Developments now. It has been more than 24 hours since the Senate voted to approve Judge Brett Kavanaugh to the Supreme Court in a vote of 50-48. Justice Kavanaugh was sworn in last night and is now officially an associate justice on the Supreme Court. Our local delegation has continued to weigh in on this vote, and Eyewitness News reporter Eric Halpern is live in the studio with more on that. Hi, Eric.
Kate, Senator Jack Reed is back in the Ocean State after being in D.C. yesterday on the Senate floor when Justice Kavanaugh was confirmed to the Supreme Court. Now, he's calling for a change when it comes to voting on Supreme Court justices.
Judge Kavanaugh is now the 9th justice on the Supreme Court after being sworn in during a private ceremony with his family, Chief Justice John Roberts, and retired Justice Anthony Kennedy, who he's replacing. None of Rhode Island's congressional delegation supported Kavanaugh.
I think there's a lot of people concerned, setting aside the very serious allegations, just his temperament at the hearing also raised serious questions.
Just a day after his confirmation hearing, they were marching in the Federal Hill Columbus Day Parade. Senator Jack Reed shares Congressman David Cicilline's thoughts on Kavanaugh's temper as someone who is now a Supreme Court justice.
Because he has to convey, or she has to convey, the notion of impartiality and restraint and control, and he frankly didn't do that.
Both also say the FBI investigation into sexual assault allegations against Kavanaugh from Dr. Christine Blasey Ford was incomplete. Since the beginning, Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell has defended Kavanaugh. He did so again Sunday morning on CBS's Face the Nation.
It was a close vote, an important vote. I think we were able to establish that the presumption of innocence is still important in this country.
Kavanaugh was voted in by a narrow margin, 50-48. Looking ahead to future Supreme Court nominations, Senator Reed says at least 60 votes in the Senate should again be needed, as was the case for most previous nominees.
Because it would force any president, Republican or Democrat, to send someone up that had bipartisan support.
And Justice Kavanaugh's first official day on the job will be Tuesday. In studio, I'm Eric Halpern, Eyewitness News.